Hey guys, welcome back to Trains. As you can see, it's still here. Well, I've mended it after the many save problems I had. The track is intact from what you saw last time, apart from one addition over here, as I'll show you in a second, a couple little additions down here. And, well, scenery wasn't intact. All this is gone, so I've basically redone it. I've done it as close as I can to last time. To be honest, you know, I was doing it ad hoc, so I don't know exactly what I did last time, so it is what it is. You got the idea from the last show how to do it, and I just refined it. I will carry on refining it as well as we go along. As you can see, I've set the water to actually move. I think that looks quite nice. Look at that. I think it's going to be a pretty area here. A little village along this side. Now, let's look over here. Now, I've added this in. It's a siding, obviously, as you can see, it comes out. And this is actually a portal. Now, what portals can do, if you have multiple portals, you can get a train to go in it from one and then out of it from another. But what we're going to do is it'll go in here, it'll wait 1 minute, and it'll come back out again the other way. So this is just a special service which will go from here, round here, into the sidings this side. The train will detach from the carriages. Train will turn around, run up the side, come back down here, connect to the other end of the carriages, and off it goes back around to it again. That's the idea. Whether we actually get that working or not is another question. You may see a few problems or little differences with the track here, but generally it's the same. It's about here where it's severed. I don't know how it managed to just delete the whole lot that side. I think the save is just completely gone. But that's life. So what I'm going to do today, and over the next week or so, because this is filmed over a period of time, is fill out this tunnel so we can actually have scenery over the top. Probably put a hill round here, and probably a hill this side. And if we get time, then we'll start looking at the town here. This is going to be industrial down this part. And probably we're going to have some trees or something to cover up this bit here. But certainly for today's episode, we're going to start off doing this. And as we go along, and I'll be saying what we're going to do next. I'm not exactly sure, because as I said, this isn't filmed today. This is filmed over the next week or so. And then I put it all together and talk over the top as it speeds up. And I cut it all into some sort of show. Okay, guys, let's get going. Well, the first thing we're going to do is look for some backdrops. Now, backdrops, as you can see from here, are... Well, effectively, if they're in the real life, they're bits of card with scenery on the back. So we're doing virtual versions of these, and I'm just looking right now which one I would like. Now, my original idea was, and I'm going to say it straight away, but I don't use it in the end, was to put a backdrop in front of that tunnel and one running all along the back. And then merge it in with some trees and things. Later on you'll see I changed the idea, but right now we're just looking to see what ones we could actually use. Most of them, unfortunately, are too small. Yeah, here we go. I think this is the one we actually use for the main back. All the way to the right. Now you see the idea. The idea was literally just to put a few trees in front. You can sync it up and down the backdrops, just like most of the scenery and stuff. You see on the menu there is quite a few different backdrops you can choose from. I've downloaded a few. Now I'm raising the scenery up. I'm going to start to make the hills. Now you get a much better feel for the hills if you use a bigger radius. The problem with using a small one, you get lots of lumps. And you're also going to see, I spent ages trying to iron out a lot of these lumps once I put them in. I wasn't very happy. So we might as well do the whole of this side while we're at it. Yep, as I said before, we're going to put Hill right in the middle. That's so the town in the middle and the town at the end, the village at the end, which I've got to think it's the names of these two places yet. They don't really see each other. We will be on a road down there though at some point. Now, as I used a small radius, I wasn't very happy. I went and made it all lumpy. It's very lumpy around here. I also don't like the fact that the hill goes down right at the back. That's what I'm trying to correct a lot of the time. I want it to just go straight upwards. It's just America's keep trying. And at some point I actually realise you can actually set the height of it. That's a bit further on the recording, unfortunately. So now we start mucking about the backdrop again. I'm trying to lower it a little bit. The problem with these backdrops, it's actually getting it. Oh, I'm going to press add a new one by accident. But it's actually grabbing hold of it once you put it in. But there's a splice point, there it is. So I've managed to get it. See, these backdrops and these are the items you can place on there. You can literally hold down anywhere on them and it'll just select them, but on some of them, like this particular backdrop, you have to hold down on that little round circle, the splice point. Now here I'm trying to be clever. Because this backdrop isn't long enough, I'm trying to put two of the same one in. Then we're going to hide that with some other scenery later on. When you're doing that, you need to put kind of the same height, so it just abruptly finishes. It doesn't look that good. Well, back to the hills again. But don't worry, we do actually get past it eventually. The other issue when you're playing with the height is the track. If you start messing around with it too much, then, well, you'll see later on the track actually becomes angled because it's going around the contour of the hill. Then you have to fix that. I don't think we end up using this one. No, we don't. We delete it. I thought so. This one's quite a good backdrop. You can actually change its width. You don't want it too wide though, otherwise it doesn't look real. So again, as I mentioned, you want to match the height as much as possible. But unfortunately I'm using a too small radius on this, so creating lots of lumps here. Again, it gone down at the back, and I'm just trying to have it so it just looks like it's gradually going upwards. You don't want it too uniformed, I think, but you do. You don't want it lumpy as well. And if you're not careful, what you saw there, that as you're moving the height of the the land, you're actually moving the height of the backdrop as well. So you do have to be careful. At some point, we have to think of the transition between this bit and the working over the corner there, where the points are, where the turntable is. Because that's meant to be a working area, that's meant to be sort of grimy and horrible, but this is meant to be countryside along here. I think at this point I've actually worked out you can actually use the height tool. Let's send that, still set on zero. Here we go, 8, there we go. That way it's a little less lumpy. Put another backdrop in and we'd take it just beyond the hill. Another spice point in, because then what we can do is just bring it down a little bit at that point. And then we just high up the earth and a tiny bit. We're getting very close now to actually adding the scenery in. So I'm looking for trees now. I'm looking for the less good looking trees, but the ones which come in bulk. There's two sets really on here as assets. You can either add a single tree which is really nicely animated, or a bunch of trees that's less animated. And it's better to put the better trees at the front, near where you're going to be, and the bulk trees at the back, just like I'm doing here. It's just a matter of finding them. So the good thing about these trees, they actually match the backdrop, the colour, but the bad thing is they're so small. I couldn't find anything else with that any bigger. I might have to go down to the download station. That's where you download the scenery from. See if I can actually find some more. I'll probably do that before the next episode, actually. I'll take that tree out very soon. It's way too close to the track, that tree. Problem is, I take it the backdrop by accident as well. But there's an undo button, so that got rid of that. And by accident, I also deleted the scenery here. Now I'm just realising that. So I figure, alright then, we'll try and mask it a different way. Now there is a bank you can actually download. And this is what I'm looking for right now. Now I'm trying to do it on the flat so you can actually find it. By the way, it's not there, but that's it. I think that's the one we're going to use. So now it's sort of crawling it over. So deleting all the other bits of scenery to put those back in afterwards. That's it. We're basically pretty much hidden it already. Obviously, then we're going to put some scenery on top of it. There's quite a few times that when I was messing about with it, it just seemed to disconnect. And that's worrying. So pick a tunnel. It kind of fits. Once you've got the other scenery, you won't notice any difference. So now what I'm trying to do here is just put the tree on top and then raise it up. I was hoping for with these bushes that they would actually sit quite nicely on top, and to an extent they do, but some of them though they do look like they're floating, and I didn't like that in the end. Yeah, it's just like most things, you just keep trying until you actually find something you actually do like. Right now, I'm just pretty much pondering what to do here. So I'm thinking maybe some smaller trees, sets of trees, and I found this set here. Fast Shrubbery Group 7. Again, it's not particularly well rendered, but that's what we want. Just something for the back. And then, as you can see, I delete those. A few more of these, I think. And these are slightly better rendered. They don't look as square, but as you can see, they still are. If you look what they are, there's just four flat pieces of texture, really. At this point, I found a couple of nicer trees. I really want to put an oak somewhere. I put one at each end. You can see the difference between this tree, which is very well rendered, and one of the other ones, which is basically four flat edges. Now it's time to put hedge in. So we don't want people wandering onto the track. So what we do is put this hedge one side, but we're going to decorate a little bit more also later on. Now I'm looking for something different the other side, because as much as it looks nice to have something that's uniformed, in reality, life isn't uniformed, is it? When have you ever seen the same bush both sides? So in the end, I actually opt for a fence. And we're going to put a fence both sides, actually. We're going to put a fence in that hedge as well. So the hedge will be moved to actually where the fence is. Just move it out a little bit and then move the hedge in. Now all the track all on the whole circuit really does need to be. Yeah, this is why I work out the track array slightly. And as much as the train will run on it, it will look horrible. So, bring the fence a little bit all round. As I was saying before, we do need to actually put fences or something all the way around. We'll use different types of fences here and there, because it's mostly the landowners, if you think about putting the fences up. It's part of their field, so. I suppose originally, when the tracks went down, the train companies would have put them down, but I suppose later on they're maintained by the landowners. In the countryside, I suppose, but in the towns, I suspect it's different. Again, what we're trying to do now is divide this up into a field. Side. What I'm thinking is a gate between those two hedges, so I found one. It's the first one, it's the only one I've got of this type actually. Do a good look. I didn't really like the colour, if I'm honest. I wanted something a bit more worn, but I didn't find it. Maybe there was something on the downline center. I've brought it back and I found this, the walking gate, so I figured why not put that in. I don't know when they're introduced actually. So what I'm trying to do is just flatten the earth a little bit so it looks like the gate could be open. Then I see that hill at the back. I'm thinking, how could anyone actually farm or do anything on this land? Around the corner, so we do the same thing, we just move a gate in on this one. This one's slightly easier because it's basically flat at the bottom. At this point I'm thinking, okay, got the gate, so they're going to go through it somehow to somewhere. So I'm thinking probably they're going to go up through those woods somewhere. So what I started looking for now is a road, but a mud track. I had seen one on here. And eventually I do find it, but as you can see, it doesn't look particularly good. So we try it and we just delete it. In theory, it's a good idea. Got the track cover, but it doesn't. It looks awful, doesn't it, really? It doesn't match the ground texture. It looks papery. And then you look on the side, it's floating as well. So I just delete it back. Then I look for, I think it's mud colour I go for. Now the problem with this is the radius of the painting tool isn't small enough to actually just do that. Which is a pity, but it still gives you an impression where the track could be. I'll make it a little bit browner where the woods are, because as you know, if you've got woods, it's generally not grass and underneath there. There's not enough sunlight goes in. Unfortunately, we don't keep it, but it's a nice addition. Might put it somewhere else, because it goes off into floating time. It can levitate, this tractor. We do keep this one though. So what I'm doing now, I don't like the uniformity of this bush, so I'm just adding lots of little bushes in. Now we'll probably do something else like this as well. On the around the track area, I can't believe that it would be no bushes or weeds on around this sort of track bed. I think it's just what I'm just doing is choosing a random one and just going up and down. I generally add about three at a time. Doing the same thing on this hedge up here. Okay, it's just the uniformity you want to get rid of, I think. So I just keep the same one, this head up and down, and just keep. Then I change it again, I go up and down, change to another one, go up and down, and I do think the backdrops add a lot to it. If the backdrop wasn't there and you're just adding this in, I think it wouldn't look half as good. Really, I'm trying to sort of mix in the background with the foreground here. So you can't tell which is a tree and which is the background. I mean, obviously you can, but it's less so, I suppose. So I think it's probably a good idea to add the ballast in here. We haven't done so now. I only placed this in just before we started today, the session. Now I think, wouldn't it be nice to actually have a farmer with the tractor there? I don't think it looks very British, but so that's why I face them the other way. I think it's more Italian, actually. By me looking at the tractor like it's broken down, it's like, what am I going to do? Oh dear. So now I'm just playing with this long grass. I figured that certainly in some places at least, the grass will probably be overgrown. Now I do look, I think it's probably too much. I think it's too brown, it's too large an area. Again, well, it's looking exactly what I don't want to look, uniformed. And so I pretty much undo it. I was trying to delete parts of it here. All I could grab is the fence. So I just undo it. I find this small one, but again, I think we use this one in the end. It matches the other grass which is there, a lot smaller. It might get changed before this gets finished, but I'm not sure. Just adding some other weeds in just to sort of mix it up a little bit. Go for that colour because it simply matches the colour of the main hedge behind. Again, all this is subject to change. Nothing has to be definite. Now I think I adjust the tracks a little bit. The height of the track still isn't right. I didn't notice that earlier. There we go. I am starting to do that here. Well guys, that's it for another episode. I thought for the last bit we'd just have a little drive around what we've been building. Unhygienically, I've put a few milk wagons with some oil trucks there as well. Look at that side, that's where the scenery is. I think right now it looks quite good. It's a bit blurry, the backdrops, but I think we need to put some high-res trees in front of it. Now, you might see up there. Perhaps you can't. I had some cows in. And some sheep. And look in front. I had a tunnel. Now there's a lot of work on that tunnel, so we'll be doing that next episode. But I want you to add a divide between this nice scenery part. And the more industrial part we're gonna have the other side. Oh yes, you've got some horses at the top there as well. Can we get rid of some of this stuff? We can get rid of that. We can sort of half that. It's not too bad. Trying to get screenshots here. All for the thumbnail for the still some kinks in the track. I have spent a little bit more time trying to get rid of it. I think we need to bring it over a little bit more. So it's, you see, on that side, less space between the track. I don't like the cars also. Even though I've set the time to around 1970, because that's the earliest I can set it, we're still getting cars from now. Anyway, if you like the video, please like it. If you would like to see more, please subscribe. And thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time, guys. Cheers and bye-bye.